Eskrima versus Iaido. Which martial art is better? If you are familiar with martial arts, then you would have heard about Eskrima and Iaido. These are two commonly known martial arts within the martial arts circle. In this video, we'll be exploring their history, their primary objectives, and conclude by giving our opinion on which of these two martial arts we believe is better. Watch through to the end to find out what we think. Before we dive in, kindly hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and smash that bell icon so you are notified the second we upload new content. All right, with that done, let's get down to business. Also known as Arnis or Kali, Eskrima is the national martial art of the Philippines. It is a martial art that is focused on the use of weapons and incorporates a range of them, including sticks, knives, bladed weapons, and other improvised weapons. Despite its emphasis on weapons, Eskrima involves open-hand combat techniques as well. The origin of Eskrima can be traced back to a period of intense conflicts between several pre-Hispanic Filipino tribes or kingdoms. Some theories link the origin of Eskrima to India. These theories insist that the martial art arrived at the Philippine Islands thanks to travelers who came through Indonesia and Malaysia, having picked up the ancient Indian martial art Salambam on their way to the Philippines. The more predominant narrative, however, is that Eskrima was practiced among the native Filipino people, many of whom were commoners who lived in poverty. The martial art was not known to be practiced amongst many of the society's elite and noble people. Early records written by the first Spanish explorers to visit the Philippine Islands indicate that a weapon-based martial art was widely practiced amongst the natives before their arrival. Although direct links between this ancient martial art and modern Eskrima have not been well established, many believe that the link exists. Early Spanish records report that the first Spanish settlers fought native tribesmen who were armed with sticks and knives, two prominent weapons of choice in the modern-day Eskrima. While the Philippines was eventually conquered by the Spanish, it is unclear how much of an influence the Spanish rule had on Eskrima as a martial art, but most historians agree that there was a considerable influence, as is reflected in the name Eskrima. After the Spanish colonized the Philippines, a decree was made that prohibited civilians from carrying full-size swords like the kris or the kampalan. This, however, did not stop practitioners of Eskrima, as they found a way to keep the art alive by resorting to sticks made of rattan in place of swords. They also used small knives as weapons and wielded them like swords in combat. Modern Eskrima combines the native fighting techniques of the Philippines with old Spanish fencing techniques. And over time, a degree of systematization has established this martial art as unique to the Philippines. There is a culture of blade carrying in the Philippines, implying that people in the Philippines are more likely to carry a knife than a gun. Although many of the people in the Philippines carry knives for their day-to-day activities, especially farmers and food vendors, these knives, which can be so easily concealed, can also double as devastating combat weapons. This culture is a reflection of the martial arts style of the Philippines. Students learning Eskrima are taught to fight with weapons from the onset and are only allowed to advance to empty hand training after they have mastered stick and knife techniques. Many Eskrima systems begin by training students with two weapons, which could be a pair of sticks or a combination of a stick and a wooden knife. This method of combat trains the students to be ambidextrous, as they are taught never to move both hands in the same direction. Another feature of Eskrima, called the live hand, involves the use of a free hand to control, trap, or disarm the opponent's weapon. The free hand is also used to block attacks from the opponent or to execute simultaneous motions of the arm, such as a technique called the bicep destruction. The most notable weapons used in Eskrima are a range of sticks, edged weapons, including a variety of blades, and other flexible weapons such as a sarong, ikut, latigo, and tabak toyak, all of which are different kinds of ropes. Now to the Japanese martial art, iaido. Iaido is a martial art that relies heavily on the use of the Japanese longsword called the katana. The martial art focuses on the mastering of sword drawing techniques that are performed with smooth and efficient motion to devastating effect. While iaido can be an aggressive martial art, practitioners are trained to develop an imposing presence and a mental pressure that they use to dissuade an opponent as much as they can until the only option left is to resort to the katana. Nevertheless, a key feature of this martial art is to train practitioners to be extremely alert and able to draw out their swords quickly to respond to sudden attacks. In line with this, iaido has four major components. The first is the smooth and controlled movement involved in drawing your sword from its scabbard. This is followed by striking or cutting the opponent to inflict damage, after which the blood on the blade is carefully removed and the sword is placed into its scabbard. All these ought to be done in smooth, sweeping motions. New students usually practice iaido using a wooden sword, also known as a boken, for safety reasons. Otherwise, they could use a blunt-edged sword called iato. More experienced practitioners are, however, allowed to use a sharp-edged sword in training. Despite the history of iaido, the hundreds of styles of swordsmanship involved in this martial art subscribe to non-combative aims and purposes. In many ways, iaido is a reflection of the morals of the classical Japanese warrior, and this martial art is ultimately seen as a means to develop a person in spiritual harmony who also possesses high intellect, resolute will, and sensitivity. It is for this reason that iaido is often performed and practiced as a solo art. Practitioners execute their style and form against one or more imaginary opponents in an activity known as kata. The non-fighting aspect of iaido means that its primary emphasis is on the precise, controlled, fluid motion executed by the practitioner. In fact, in some schools, the practice of the tamashigiri, or the cutting techniques of iaido, is not done. If we were to pick between the ancient forms of eskrima and iaido, that would have been a tough one. But looking at the modern forms of both martial arts, choosing between the two would be dependent on personal interest. Clearly, the combative aspects of iaido have been greatly toned down in recent times. But if you are looking for a martial art that is more about discipline and self-development than actual combat, then iaido is the better option. However, eskrima will serve you better if you are looking to train yourself in self-defense. Learning to defend yourself using a concealed weapon gives you the advantage of the element of surprise and puts you in a position to defend yourself more effectively. So, do you agree or disagree with our opinion? Let us know what you think in the comments section. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.